Nicholas Swinton, then a 29-year-old clerk, visited Prague, Czechoslovakia in late 1938 at the invitation of his friend from the British Embassy. He spent only a couple of months assisting in refugee camps before he realized the danger posed by the imminent Nazi invasion. Winston immediately recognized the danger and made every effort possible to get the children to safety. After the war, Nicholas Winton kept his wartime rescue efforts and achievements secret. His deeds went unrecognized for over half a century and would have stayed so if it wasn't for his late wife, who found a scrapbook in the attic with all the children's photos, a complete list of names, a few letters from parents of the children to Winton, and other documents. Nicholas Winton was first faced with the children he rescued in a television show. He was given no indication of what to expect.
All the letters. But back here is the list of all the children. This is Vera Diamant, now Vera Gissing. We did find her name on his list. Vera Gissing is with us here tonight. Hello, Vera. And I should tell you that you are actually sitting next to Nicholas Winton.
Hello. And it was just so wonderful, so terribly, terribly touching.
Is there anyone in our audience tonight who owes their life to Nicholas Winton? If so, could you stand up, please?
Well, the idea for the Bratislava History Project came from a conversation I had with the British ambassador to Slovakia, Michael Roberts, who proposed that Nicholas Winton be invited to Bratislava at the time of the Queen's visit, the state visit. And of course, as a history teacher, the first thing was the opportunity to undertake some oral history with some historically significant characters.
So 4 years ago, during history lessons, we were studying Second World War and Sir Nicholas Winton, and then this fantastic opportunity came to meet him.
Meeting Joe Schlesinger was one of the most amazing things during this project.
Well, Lord Dubs was amazing. He had so much to say. He was so willing to talk as much as we wanted him to.
Beyond that, it was going to be an opportunity, I think, also to work with other schools, to acquire leadership experience.
For me, to be a leader of a team was a completely new thing, and that's why it was maybe the most difficult thing also.
The challenges of leadership were mainly to stay nice, but still to lead a team.
You know, we were online non-stop, right, 24/7. Yeah. And you know, constructing all the things, posting comments, you know, urging people to do it, and you know,
basically it was, living on the forum.
Yeah, it was an amazing way of communicating, you know, with schools in England.
Finally, and perhaps most importantly, it was the opportunity to make the most of the new technology that we have in the school that has enabled us to run IB Film, and for the filmmakers to exploit that technology and to make a genuinely interesting historical documentary.
It was one of the most amazing experiences of my life.
It was absolutely amazing.
Came along, she shook my hand, said something I didn't understand.
Something totally different than I expected. It wasn't so tense. Yeah.
And I really felt like we bonded.
Yeah, there was definitely a connection between the two of us and her. After, you know, all the camera crews went and the queen have left, you know, there was Sir Nicholas Winton sitting on a chair next to Joe Schlesinger, and, you know, it just felt like the perfect opportunity to pop in and, you know, and ask him some questions.
If you could give one piece of advice for future generations, something you have learned from your life, what would it be?
Don't be content in your life just to do no wrong. Be prepared every day to try and do some good.